Today I was conducting a focus walk here in third grade.
Hi there. A quote from the text here, a quote from the text over there, a quote from the text here.
So I'm looking to see that a majority of the class time is spent reading, writing, or speaking directly about text. And I noticed the students are consistently working on that.
Essential means necessary and important.
It's simply a 7-minute walkthrough of a lesson where we're collecting data and it's completely anonymous to the teacher. We're looking to see if the practices that we're sharing during our professional development here in Huntington is actually taking part, translating into the classroom.
A focus walk is essentially an informal classroom walkthrough that is designed to do just that, focus on specific instructional aspects in an attempt to have our teachers and students focus on something very specific.
All right, so I'm ready. Let's go. Hi, Mrs. Scott. I'm going to come into your room and Mary Beth is going to go too.
Okay.
I forgot to bring the two.
Oh,
this year we instituted the focus walks and wanted to really strengthen our practice through that and support the implementation of the Common Core. The SDLE grant has been instrumental in allowing us to do that because we were able to focus not only as a district but as individual schools on what we thought the priorities should be.
When I was doing staff development this year with teachers, they were concerned about the focus walks and we talked about it and I said the purpose of the focus walk is to see where do we need to change our professional development and our staff development. If we think we want to see fluency activities and we go in and we don't see them, then we know that we have to, you know, bring that to you all and show you what to do.
The focus walks are a part of life here. It's just normal. One of the suggestions from the focus walks was to enhance group work, to do station activities, and we did implement that in the classroom. The students really took to it. They like it. It's a change of pace. It gets them moving around the classroom, and we've seen good results from it.
So remember, 7 change to an 8, and then we're good to go. There's always times during any lesson where you're going to miss an opportunity maybe to ask more of a deep question, or maybe you jumped in a little bit early when maybe you should have stepped back and allowed the kids to work a little bit more. So having that pointed out, I think, is always good to keep it in mind for the next time.
What I noticed is I saw a lot of students sharing their information. Could you talk about what you saw, you know, when they were sharing?
What we saw in the beginning is that teachers thought there was more group work going on, and as we have continued this process during the year, we've seen a change and a shift so that students are working in stations or groups and or pairing together with their students or pairing, and we really have found that it's not a teacher-centered classroom, it's a student-centered classroom.
This is data-driven, just like everything else that we've been trying to do. This is data-driven. When you are able to look objectively at data that tells you you're not quite there yet, that's when you have the impetus to work and to change and to make it happen.
It's been a huge success. We really have seen the vocabulary being used at the elementary schools skyrocket. So I have felt that the SDLE grant through these focus walks have really improved the quality of math instruction in the district.
We all learn from one another. It's not just me talking to the teachers, telling them, follow me, follow what I'm doing. I'm showing them that I'm learning and that we're really in this together.
The great success is we have been able to utilize the feedback to alter instructional practices in a manner that we believe is going to do as much good as possible for our students in terms of, okay, of their performance and in essence, helping them to generate a love of learning in all different settings.